call the regular meeting of the board to order. We'll stand and be led in the pledge by Mr. Howard. Thank you, Mr. Howard. I feel lonely in here, kind of like there's an echo or something. Can I roll call, please?
Mr. Howard?
Present.
Mr. Lawson? Mr. Levinstein?
Here.
Mr. Lewis? Ms. McAfee? Ms. Brokaw?
Here.
Ms. Resch? Mr. Woodhall? Ms. Fuchek?
Here. First item on the agenda is a report from the superintendent.
Thank you, Madam President. The first presentation is a capital project update from Terry Damon. And Terry is at the microphone now.
Good evening. Thank you. I know you received in your packets last week for the workshop a copy of our monthly status update report. I wanted to touch on a couple of the highlights from that report. The most important being the projects that we currently had at SED for permitting, for the work that Town, GAMS, and NFA main campus. As was reported in the update, the State Education Department has seen an increase in projects, and their mechanical, electrical, plumbing review teams are currently about 16 to 20 weeks behind their architectural review teams. That being said, it looks like the only project we're going to have permits for that will allow us to start some work this summer will be the Foster Town project. We did get our permit. That project is currently out for bid. Bids will be received on May 14th, and we'll be presenting those recommendations for contract awards, assuming everything is in order for action at the end of May. The GAMS project, which included an art room, some work in the kitchen area, and some student lockers. We will likely do the student locker work via state contract, much the same way that we've done some of the furniture fixtures and equipment installation. So we will have the lockers in place for September for the sixth grade students. With regard to the work at NFA, the work in this building was very mechanical, electrical, plumbing intensive. We had the existing weight room conversion to a girls' locker room. We had the dish room work, the lower level cafeteria. So those projects, we do not yet have the permit. We are hopeful we'll get the permit before the end of summer. And if we do, we should be able to start and complete the girls' locker room, the weight room conversion project in the fall. There is an outside separate entrance into that space, and it's isolated in the building. We think we might be able to do that work this fall. All remaining work would be pushed to next summer. The other two items that were in your packet for review, the second is the budget resolutions, which you have. We haven't received any questions, so I'm assuming everybody's understanding what we're doing there. It's a reallocation of savings that we have approved to cover some of the new work that was just mentioned at NFA and GAMS. The final item, there was a question on the change orders for the cores at GAMS. There's a supplemental write-up that was placed at each one of your seats before the meeting that provides further detail in regard to what that change order was for and the cost associated with that work. Unless anyone has questions, that's kind of a brief overview of our update report from this past month.
Any questions for Mr. Damon? Okay, thank you, Mr. Damon.
Thank you. That ends that section of the agenda, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Pizzo. Next item on the agenda is public discussion and comment on agenda items. Anyone wishing to speak on agenda items, please step to one of the microphones and give your name and address. Next item on the agenda is from the board president. I have a resolution to suspend suspend bylaw number 0130A. Be it resolved that the Board of Education hereby suspends bylaw number 0130A, which requires two readings prior to the adoption or amendment of a policy, to allow policy number 5201, secondary course credit, to be amended on one reading. Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis? Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Bucher?
Yes. Next item on my agenda is the adoption of policy number 9200, parental involvement, and policy number 5201, secondary school course credit. May I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Bucher?
Yes. My final item this evening is a resolution to appoint deputy clerks, election inspectors, chairpersons, and machine technicians for the purpose of assisting the district clerk in conducting the school and library budget vote election on May 21st, 2013. Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Bucher?
Yes. That concludes my items for this evening. Our next item on the agenda is from the superintendent.
Thank you, Madam President. Resolution A is to approve facilities project change orders associated with approved project, South Middle School, GAMS renovation.
Any motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Bucher?
Yes.
Resolution B is to accept and revise the project budget summary for the capital renovation project from the $50 million capital project.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Bucher?
Yes.
Resolution C is to accept revised project budget summary for the capital renovation project, $76.5 million capital project.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Bucher?
Yes.
Resolution D is to approve facility use request.
Can I have a motion?
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Bucher?
Yes.
That concludes this session of the agenda, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Pizzo. Our next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent for Student Intervention and Support Services.
Thank you, Madam President. I have one item for you tonight, and that is to arrange for the placement of students with disabilities as recommended by the District's Committee on Special Education and Committee on Preschool Special Education, and approve the authorization of funds to implement special education programs and services consistent with those recommendations.
May I have a motion?
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Bucher?
Yes.
Thank you, Madam President. That's it for student intervention and support services.
Thank you, Mrs. Rowland. Our next item on the agenda is from the Executive Director for Curriculum and Instruction.
is a resolution to authorize the superintendent of schools, the board president, and director of career readiness to execute an articulation agreement with Ryan Stratton College.
May I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Ms. Bucek?
Yes.
Item B is a resolution to authorize the superintendent of schools to execute an amended consultant agreement with PASPA, reducing the scope of work, services, and compensation. And the funding source is the systemic support for district and school turnaround grant.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis? Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Ms. Bucek?
Yes.
Item C is a resolution to approve an overnight field trip with the NFA track team to compete at the Penn Rallies April 25th to 27th, 2013. Funding source, general fund athletics.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Ms. Bucek?
Yes.
Item D is a resolution to approve an overnight field trip for NFA students to Black Rock Forest from May 3rd to 4th, 2013. The funding source is Black Rock Forest.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Ms. Bucek?
Yes.
And my final item is item E, the resolution to approve conference request.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop? Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Ms. Bucek?
Yes.
And that concludes my items.
Thank you, Dr. Shanahan. Our next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent for Business.
Thank you, Madam President. First item is a resolution to authorize the award of 2012-2013 district transportation bid.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Ms. Bucek?
Yes.
Item B is a resolution to authorize the awarding of the 2012-2013 cafeteria bids.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Ms. Bucek?
Yes.
Item C is a resolution to authorize the awarding of the 2012-13 spring athletic transportation bid.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Yes, Ms. Prokosh.
I did, and Mr. Major provided the explanation you should be receiving in the update. I know that when we spoke, one of these places, one was at the middle school, one was at the high school. This was the explanation that I received, and then the other one I just don't remember, but he provided the explanation on the one that you did question.
But
why wasn't JV using South Middle School?
Yeah, that answer, that wasn't the transportation piece, that was something separate. Right. The reason why it's South Middlefield is being used, the South Field is being used by South. Heritage is being used by Heritage, and the home field for the JV team is, what was the other one?
Steve?
Which I didn't hear.
You have two fields within the district. Mm-hmm. You should use it, those two fields, whatever game, rather than have to, you know, have that.
field's not within the district. That's in the district.
Is it a district field?
No, it's not a district home field, but South Middle School is still being used by South Middle School team.
Modified softball.
If I may, the Rashani Field is given to us to use because we have a receptacle deal with them, with the salt in winter time. And they let us use the field, same thing as we have in the town of Newburgh. So we're not paying anything for that field. It's being used by our team.
I feel like the field, well, was the field, that it should be used in the district. But the other thing is the education.
And it's my understanding that Mr. Major provided that for the update. And I didn't get a chance to look at the update, but I presume that it went Friday in the board packet. That was the instructions to him. In the update.
Back Friday?
This past Friday.
Also, in regards to the transportation, Ms. Prokosh, if he's saying that we're using South Middle School for modified softball, if we were going to use it for JV, they'd be being transported to South Middle School instead of Rashani Park. So there's still.
One of the biggest things is we built these fields
right.
On school property. In my mind, we should be using these fields
right.
On school property for teams.
Right.
No, otherwise, why build them?
Right. No, I agree.
But we are.
And you don't play 5 days a week home games on the field. So there's enough days to schedule to have teams play out at the door for the big field.
But I'm just guessing here, if modified is using South, if South Middle School student modified team is using that field for games, then on the days that they're not there for games, I'm assuming they'd be having practice on that. The backup documentation and that it went in the packet.
I mean, the board members seem to be agreeing that we didn't see it.
Right. No, I'm not saying that it was in there.
Well, I asked you, so that's why I was asking
for confirmation. And I asked Mr. activity, so it's not there. But if they're assuming that it was put in the packet, you know, they wouldn't be looking, they wouldn't expect that we would have the question, where's the information, because they're assuming that it's in the packet.
I'm on our
dead horse.
But I know we have four financial constraints.
So anywhere we can save.
So if we can save money.
Yep.
On certain things, then we should save money. We have two teams going to an event on the same bus, we're saving money. If the bus, we must.
That's substantial.
Sure.
That's substantial when we send our, you know, JV and our varsity together. And if somebody's got to hang out and wait, they've got to hang out and wait.
The athletic director and the department was directed to do just that at the beginning of the year.
And I talked about it last year.
No, he's been doing it this year. I didn't get a chance to review I did look at the one I called him up on the two issues that he had. I believe there was two events. And he provided an explanation. I said, we need to provide that to the board so that we have that. There were different locations. One was the high school, one was the middle school. And I don't know the full reasons, and I apologize for not having all the information here tonight. But they were directed to do that at the beginning of the year to double up on the teams per bus in order to save money. Item D is a resolution to declare equipment and supplies obsolete and authorize disposition of the same.
Any motion?
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Kuchek?
Yes.
Item E is a resolution to accept donation from the Hudson Valley Building Construction Trade Council of Orange and Dutchess Counties.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Kuchek?
Yes.
Item F is a resolution to authorize payment of property tax refunds pursuant to court orders. The first one is for the Land Investment Group, $2,832.93, and the second one is for Vincent and Maria Marino. Amount of $7,954.86.
And motion?
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Redd? Ms. Kuchin?
Yes.
Item G is a resolution to accept the monthly bills and reports.
And motion?
So moved.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Redd?
Yes.
Ms. Kuchek?
Yes.
Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Pasella. Our next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent of Human Resources.
Thank you, Madam President. On the Human Resources agenda, items A through K,
have on the professional side return from leave of absence, retirements, Schedule J resignations, and on the civil service side, we have appointments, change of status, leave of absence, return from leave of absence, change of location, new retirement, and then former employees who have passed away.
Make a motion.
So moved.
Questions or comments? Yes, Mr. Levinson.
Just have a couple of questions, please. I just want to make sure that I understand the unpaid leave of absence. So just some questions, because I've heard some things about it. This is something that employees ask for. What range of time is it? Is it from a week to a month? Or what's the range that people ask for that unpaid leave?
The range could be from a day up to a year. For a multitude of reasons.
Okay.
The reasons could be a medical reason, educational, childcare. So.
Okay. So, and when that time period is up, do sometimes they ask for additional time?
They can. And that comes back to if there's any change in the length or duration of the original leave. Any change in that comes back to you for.
Okay, so in this time period that we're not paying them, there's unpaid leave, do they get benefits from the district?
If it's FMLA leave, the family medical leave, they, for 60 days of that unpaid leave, they are entitled to receive their health insurance. They have to contribute the percentage of the premium that they contribute even when they're being paid. That's still in effect. But for 60 days, they get their health insurance.
Okay, but then the unpaid one where someone asks for not family medical, and they ask for 6 months, they don't?
They have the option, they don't because they're not on payroll. We're not paying for their health insurance, but they have the option to do it on COBRA and pay it themselves.
Okay, so then this is not, I don't think what I heard the other day. So if someone's out for 6 months and for unpaid leave, and we have to have substitute coming for a semester, then we're going to be paying their health insurance for that.
We would be paying.
Which we should. Okay, but we're not paying them the unpaid.
No, if an employee's on unpaid leave, unless that we are not paying for their health insurance.
Okay, so that's not what we were told before.
Okay. And Mrs. Langer, what happens after the 60 days for those employees on the FMLA? Do they then have to pay the COBRA?
They're notified if they wish to continue their health insurance that they have to COBRA and pay the premiums.
Thank you.
Well. Any other questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Resch?
Yes.
Ms. Buchek?
Yes. Resolution L is to approve the professional change in status.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Resch?
Yes.
Ms. Buchek?
Yes. Resolution M is to approve a leave of absence and appoint Matt Otto as the Executive High School Principal of Newburgh Free Academy.
I have a motion.
So moved.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms.
Yes.
Ms. Buchek?
Yes. Resolution N is to appoint Chuck Thomas as the Director of the Newburgh Free Library.
Motion. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Red?
Yes.
Ms. Buchek?
Yes. Resolution O is to approve a leave of absence and to appoint Vinnie Lopez as the principal at Temple Hill Academy.
I have a motion.
So moved.
questions or comments? Roll, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Reg?
Yes.
Ms. Bouchette?
Yes. Resolution P is to approve an appointment for the SMART program at Indiana. Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Reg?
Yes.
Ms. Bouchette?
Yes. Resolution Q is to approve 2012-2013 schedule change. Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Reg?
Yes.
Ms. Bouchette?
Yes. Resolution R is to approve the appointments for the Learning Technology Grant Professional Development Program. Funding sources, the Learning Technology Grant. Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Reg?
Yes.
Ms. Bouchette?
Yes. Resolution S is to approve the appointments for math curriculum writing and funding sources, Title I. Make a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Reg?
Yes.
Ms. Bouchette?
Yes. And Resolution T is for your information only. It's upcoming tenure recommendations for administrators and teachers. And that concludes my answer. Thank you, Mrs. Lyman. Our next item on the agenda is from the clerk of report.
Thank you, Madam President. One item of approval of the meeting minutes for the March 19, 2013 meeting.
Make a motion. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Howard?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Brokaw?
Yes.
Ms. Reg?
Yes.
Ms. Bouchette?
Yes.
That concludes my item.
Thank you, Mr. McCoy. Item on the agenda is public discussion and comment on non-agenda items. We only have one name this evening, and after that, if you'd like to make comments on public discussion or comment on non-agenda items, I'll ask you to step in front of the microphones and give your name and address. First, we will hear from Mr. Archer.
My name is Art Clifton, president of the Newburgh Teachers Association. Tomorrow, the negotiating team of the Newburgh Teachers Association will present the contract proposal which we negotiated with the district and our members. And we will answer their questions and concerns. We'll then be put to a vote on Tuesday, May 7th, at schools, and it is my sincere hope that it is ratified. We will not know until the following week when absentee votes are returned. I would like to personally thank all of the teachers, teaching assistants, administrators, parents, and students of the three schools that were in danger of closure. It was very encouraging to hear the passion that was voiced for the educational programs in their buildings and the individual experiences shared and the concerns from those that spoke their schools. I was greatly impressed by the tenor of those that spoke, their tacit acknowledgement that there were two other schools that might face closure, and that the people from those schools were in a very similar place. There was no blaming one school or another, and the level of discourse was polite and extraordinarily respectful. I congratulate all of those that spoke. The NTA worked out a proposal with the district that includes a retirement incentive and a 4-year contract. If this is ratified, it will save jobs. If enough teachers take the retirement incentive, then the jobs of some of our younger members will be more secure. Closing the school would also have increased class sizes throughout the district. If ratified, this won't happen, and we will also keep full-day kindergarten. But this only helps for this coming year. We can't keep facing this year from year. I call on all those who spoke so valiantly for their three schools to join with teachers and administrators and Board of Education members and other community people to fight for public education. We need parents to join us, to lobby our state representatives, especially state senators, to increase funding for our schools. We should not be paying a gap elimination tax. Mandates from Albany should be appropriately funded. This will not change unless we all can work together and actively fight for our schools in Albany. I recently heard that a state senator who has refused to meet with teacher groups jumped at the chance to meet with parents from Valley Center. There is a lot of power that parents and students have with our local politicians. We need to use that. We need to promote the appropriate funding for public education and hold politicians accountable. Parents can do just that. We need to end excessive high-stakes tests that act to deny children a comprehensive education. We must keep up the struggle. Saving a school for this year is not enough. We need to work together to help all of our schools across the state. June 8th, there will be a rally in Albany for public education. People from all over will be there to support education. We need to encourage our parents to be there as well and speak truth to power. I will be there. I hope that many will join me. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Plitka. Is there anyone else that would like to speak on non-agenda items? Being none, be it resolved that the Board of Education hereby recesses into executive session for the following purpose: to discuss the employment history of particular individuals and for collective bargaining under the Taylor Law for the CSEA, NSAA, and NTA. The Board will not be taking action after executive session. Can I have a motion? Roll call, please.